Mr.
Sure.
Rajesh Jain. Yeah.
Thank you, Sanjay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. So before I start, I would just like to set a little context here that what are the other problems or all the problems that retailers are facing and would be facing in the next 6 to 9 months. 6 to 9 months is the period that I personally foresee will take to recover and get back to the stabilization period. And I'm not talking about growth. I'm merely talking about the stabilization. Once everything reopens in the country, it will take another 6 to 9 months to reopen. Now, if we see the retail per se, daily business, we earn every day by selling the goods. And then because of that earning, we are able to take care of all our overheads on a monthly basis, on a daily basis, and those kind of things. However, what has happened is since lockdown, sometime in the middle of March, that complete revenue has gone away. And in the next 6 to 9 months, we don't foresee a major recovery or even a decent percentage of what we achieved last year. And that puts us in a great troublesome period. Now, if I see at retail, there are three major components of cost. One is cost of goods sold, and that has direct relation to the inventory available in the store. Now, on one hand, the retailers have to ensure that whenever the reopening takes place, the customers walk in and they see the fresh merchandise and decent numbers and decent options. And on the other hand, the retailers have to maintain a fine balance to ensure that they don't end up locking up too much of money into that inventory because there is so much of uncertainty. Now, this we can equate how we handled it, that we tried to fish out our data post recession in 2008-2009 and post demonetization, because both of these events threw retail out of gear. And we tried to see that what happened immediately after these events and try to again project because of those what will happen in 1 year from now. That is not a good number. But at the same time, in this scenario, there is an added problem of scare amongst the customer. In earlier two occasions, the customers were still walking in, the stores were still open, some sale were still happening. But this time, the sale will not happen and the customers are not likely to walk in a hurry because of the added element of fear. Because of that, our projections are for physical stores specifically are very low. Because of this, rental, which is already a very high percentage of our sales, has become one of the biggest element as percentage to sale. And that is where we are looking for support from mall developers, from landlords in high streets, etc. I will come back to this rental part just to inform the third part, which is the personnel cost. I think there is not even a single retailer in the country who is not taking a pay cut and in some cases job losses also. My personal view is that pay cuts are better than job losses. And I think most retailers are trying to manage with that unless and until it is absolutely necessary to resort to job losses also. Coming back to the biggest cost element today, which is rental to revenue share, this is becoming the most important and the most troublesome factor for all the retailers. Here, what we are doing is we are reaching out to all the mall developers and high street landlords also, collectively also and individually also. We are reaching out, we are appealing to them to support us. I personally believe that mall developers and retailers are two sides of the same coin. Retail cannot survive or cannot grow unless there are sufficient, good, decent malls. And malls can just not survive if there are no retailers. So my personal view is that both of them are, they make the complete retail scenario as far as physical retail goes. Online retail, on the other hand, is doing wonderfully well. Whatever online retail has opened for us, that is doing decent numbers. But obviously, that cannot compensate for the entire sale because online retailer, end of the day, is only about 10 to 12% of retail sale for most of the retailers. Here, our experience has been that when we reach out to the developers, they are collaborative. They do want to talk to us. But in some places, we have been able to reach out to some amicable resolution also. And in some places, it is yet to take place. And we do hope that the